with some of the greatest guitarists of all time, greatest bands in Michigan. What's the secret of keeping this rock and roll thing going? You're 74 now.
Well, I don't smoke, drink, or do drugs.
Is that right?
Anymore.
Is that right?
Yeah. So it's, try and take care of what you got left of your body. I'll be 74 June 1st.
Who's the biggest influence on you as a guitarist?
There's a lot of them. If I had to pick one, it would be B.B. King.
B.B. King?
Yeah, I'd have to go if I had to pick one, but... I mean, Hendrix, I knew all those guys.
Yeah.
I was fortunate enough to where I was able to meet them, and I know them.
Yeah. Do you ever play jazz? You play all kinds of music?
That's what I listen to mostly at home.
Is that right?
All the Blue Note stuff. That's what I grew up with.
Yeah, is that right?
As ironic as that might sound, I don't listen to much rock and roll at home. I listen to jazz.
Is it harder to play jazz on guitar than it is rock and roll? I mean, silly question, but
No. If you're a jazz musician, it's not hard. If you're a rock and roll musician, it might be impossible.
Okay.
But if you're a jazz musician, it's not any more difficult than just playing rock and roll. It's a more sophisticated kind of music.
You know, there's a lot of young kids out there. They're just starting out right now. You're 74. What advice would you give them starting out?
I'd say if you can, stay away from the drugs. If you want to do a little drinking, that's fine. But stay away from the drugs if you're serious about your music. It just sidelines you and it causes too much problems.
All right. Thanks, Jim.
All right.
Yeah.